Good evening, everybody. Welcome to our council meeting. Again, our apologies for starting a little bit late. We were in closed session a little long, but we're here now. Let's see, we had some prelude music by the Still Point Quartet. Are you guys still here? Did they all four leave together? Okay, all right. Well, we weren't here to listen to it. How was it? Okay, excellent. Good. Well, give them a good hand. As is our tradition, we'd like to start off our meeting with an invocation, and that will be given by Elder Bob Ruiz. Elder, are you here? Elder, come on forward. And then if you can remain standing for the flag salute. We don't get to see Monty Sharp in the house too often. Monty, would you mind giving the flag salute? Thank you. Stand with me, please.
You're going to do the flag salute?
No, first invocation.
Okay.
Thanks.
Well, good evening, Mr. Mayor, Mayor Pro Tem, and council members and distinguished leaders of this community. My name is Bob Ruiz, and I'm an elder at Reliance Church. And you probably have noticed our church, it has that little Pujol schoolhouse in the front of it. It was built in 1898, and it's situated on our property. And it's my privilege and honor to be here with you distinguished leaders of this community. I thank you for your part in making this community the excellent community that it has. I've been here 8 years, my wife and I, and it's a wonderful community. I thank all of you for all that you have done to make it so. And so I open up in prayer, and if you would bow your heads. Dear Heavenly Father, I come to you on behalf of the leaders of this community to praise you and thank you for your love, grace, and mercy for all of mankind, but particularly for the way you have blessed the city of Temecula. All good comes from you, and there is much good that we as citizens take note here in Temecula. Still, there are many areas of need, such as caring for our homeless. We ask that you impart wisdom to the city leaders whom we look to for decisions to benefit all the citizens of this community. We ask you that you greatly bless the city leaders and their families. Give them strength to confront all the issues that they need to address now and in the future. We thank you, Heavenly Father, for all that you do, and we thank you for the City Council members, all the distinguished leaders that you have placed in this community. We pray these things in the almighty and holy name of Jesus Christ. Amen.
Amen.
Would you join with me?
I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America, and to the Republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
Thank you. You can be seated. Madam City Clerk, can you call the roll, please?
Councilmember Comacero?
Here.
Councilmember Edwards?
Here.
Councilmember McCracken?
Here.
Councilmember Ron?
I'm here.
Mayor Nagar?
The mayor is here. This is the presentation and proclamation portion of our meeting. And I think, let's see how I want to do this. I'd like to do, our first presentation will be a presentation of National Travel and Tourism Week in Temecula. Do we have a representative here to receive that proclamation? Madam City Clerk, do we? Come on down. And I know, I recognize Ned. Who else do you have with you? Hey.
Mayor Nagar and Mayor Pro Tem Edwards.
Tom. Yes. Yeah. I got to remember glasses. Sorry.
Tom DeMont. I'm chairman of the board of Visit Temecula Valley. And
that Bill Wilson?
It is.
It looks like Bill Wilson. Yep. And Annette Brown, staff member of Visit Temecula Valley. So on behalf of Visit Temecula Valley, we appreciate your acknowledgement of National Tourism Week. And not only that, but thank you for the years of support that you've given to the tourism industry here in Temecula. You know, through this partnership and many other stakeholders, tourism has become a vibrant and critical part of our community here in Temecula. And we've had great years in recent years and look forward to more to come. So we've really gone from being that hidden gem to being that place you have to go. So
that's right.
We're glad to be here.
Thank you, Tom. Annette or Bill, would you like to say a few words?
No, I'm just, I'm not technically in the city. I
live in wine country, but it's a really good partnership between the city and wine country. And again, we thank you for your support and our continued support of the city. And if I could do more, I would. If I could vote for you, I would, but I can't. So anyway, again, it's a true blessing. When we came out here to do the winery, we had no idea that we'd be coming to such a wonderful city in and of itself. And that I thank you and the city leaders for putting together such a beautiful community. It was by design, and that was what makes it even better that you guys planned this from the get-go. And we're now seeing the fruits of your labor, and it's pretty impressive. So thank you.
Thank you. Annette, did you want to say anything?
Also, I thank you, and I hope everybody, the citizens and the leaders, have seen the impact that tourism has had in the last several years in our community, the number of jobs that have been fulfilled through tourism, and the 2.8 million visitors that have come, and they keep coming back because they love the experience, because the people here give excellent customer service and an unforgettable experience. So thank you all.
Well, the three of you do a great job in representing the area for tourism and just in that regional economy. And we know that there's so many more of you. And please extend our thanks from the City Council to the entire group. I get the honor and privilege of reading a proclamation, if you'd bear with me. City of Temecula Proclamation. Whereas travel has a positive effect on California and the nation's economic prosperity and image abroad, and whereas impacts business productivity and individual travelers' well-being, and whereas travel to and within the United States provides significant economic benefits for the nation, generating more than $2.1 trillion in economic output, with $928.1 billion spent directly by travelers. And whereas travel is among the largest private sector employers in the United States, supporting 15 million jobs in 2014, including 8 million directly in the travel industry and 7 million in the other industries. And whereas travelers spending directly generated tax revenues of $141.5 billion for federal, state, and local governments, funds used to support essential services and programs. And whereas Temecula, California currently generates $124.2 billion in travel spending, $21 million for state taxes, and $7.5 million for local taxes, with 2.8 million visitors, which includes 1.2 million overnight visitors and over 6,500 jobs. Whereas travel spending by residents and international travelers in the U.S. averages $2.5 billion a day, and whereas travel is a pillar of economic growth, creating jobs at a faster rate than other sectors, and we have one more whereas. And whereas leisure travel, which accounts for more than three quarters of all trips taken in the United States, spurs countless benefits for travelers, health and wellness, creativity, cultural awareness, education, happiness, productivity, and relationships. Now I, therefore, Michael S. Nagar, on behalf of the City Council of the City of Temecula, do hereby proclaim May 1st through May 7th, 2016, to be National Tourism and Travel Week in Temecula. Congratulations again, and thanks for all the work you folks do. Thank you. Okay. Now, as is, we have one more presentation. I'm going to mix it up just a little differently. Usually at these meetings, we have a number of students who come for their government classes. And so I like to generally see who's here from each school. So where are my Pumas tonight? Pumas, hands up. Okay, all right. Not bad. Golden Bears? Any Golden Bears in the house? All right, all right. All right, real good. What about the Wolf Pack? Is Wolf Pack here? Wolf Pack is a no-show. All right, all right. But I get the impression, I get to call one other school out today, and that is what I'm pleased to do. Where are my Eagles? The Eagles here? That's what I'm talking about. Okay. Because we're about to celebrate the Rancho Christian School Eagles. okay, who did some, that's okay, go for it, who did some amazing things this year. So I'm going to read one of these certificates, and then Mayor Pro Tem Edwards is going to come down and present them to you as I call your name and want you to come on down here and to receive it, okay? So, City of Temecula Certificate of Achievement, presented on behalf of the City Council and the citizens of the City of Temecula to your name, you'll get one of these, of the Rancho Christian High School Eagles Boys Varsity Basketball Team. The City of Temecula congratulates blank on his outstanding accomplishments and efforts with the Rancho Christian High School Eagles Boys Varsity Basketball Team. The Eagles finished the season 2015-16 CIF Southern Section 5A champions, bringing home the first CIF title in any sport for the school and the first CIF title for any high school basketball team from Temecula. The team also won, that's right. The team also won several major titles, including 2014-15 CIF Southern Section Division 5A runners-up, 2015-16 CIF regional state finalists, and 2014-15 and 2015-16 South Valley League champions. We are proud of your name, dedication, and talent for the sport of basketball. We wish him, his coaches, and team continued success in this sport and with their future endeavors. And it's signed by me and our city clerk. And so, as fitting, what I'd like to do is, Mayor Pro Tem, I'm going to call some names. If you can go down there and hand them out.
Sure. You got a list?
Yes, I do. And when we call your name, I'd like you to come on down and line it up right down here. And then parents and relatives, friends, we're going to take some time to take some pictures because this is a big deal. Okay. So I wish I could sound like my best radio announcer's voice, okay, like I was calling the game. Trace Redfield, come on down. Isaiah Mobley. Wow.
You call from here.
Yusef Johnson. Owen Chidesester. Jamal Brower. Hey, Jay Redfield. JoJo Satzer. Peyton Friedland. Greg Walter. Solomon Davis. Josh Fuller. Assistant Coach Blake Houghton. Assistant Coach Joe Moody. And ladies and gentlemen, the coach of the Rancho Christian High School varsity team Eagles, Ray Bearfield. All right, we're gonna take all the time you need, parents and friends. Take your individual pictures and then line it up. We'll take group pictures as well.
Oh, absolutely. Yeah.
See what we can do.
Yeah. It's a lot more.
And parents and friends, don't need to be shy. You just come on down. This is great. Feel free to come on down. Mayor Pro Tem Edwards does weddings and bar mitzvahs.
I'm a mom.
You might want to get a picture of the big screen. That's always a winner. Coach, after these pictures, don't go away because we want you to say a few words, okay?
With the big picture in the picture.
You get the whole picture, though.
Yeah, that's good.
All right. All right. Real quick, boys, before you go, how many of you are seniors this year, yeah, or about to graduate? So a lot of you guys aren't going to get to play together anymore. Huh? And for you seniors, are you off to college? Just quickly, go to the podium. Let us know where you're going. Just pass by the microphone. Say your name and where you're going. And then, coach, you bring up the rear. Let's hear from the coach.
Well, I haven't decided yet, but it's going to be either UC Santa Cruz or UC Irvine.
Excellent. Thank you.
Jamal Brower, and I'm undecided.
Peyton Fridland and GCU, Grand Canyon.
Greg Walter, undecided right now.
Josh Fuller, Cal State San Marcos.
Yay. Coach, the microphone's yours.
I won't, okay. Just on behalf of Rancho Christian and our leaders, our pastor, Treadway, our head of school, Jim Kunau, our principal, Dan Satzer, just all of our leaders, we want to thank you, Mayor and the City Council, for acknowledging our team and our accomplishments. This is a very good group of kids, special young men, and it's my privilege to coach them, and we're blessed. Our school is blessed. So I just want to thank you and all of the community support for everything that, you know, they do on our behalf. So thank you very much for acknowledging us.
You're very welcome. Young men, you're a group of fine young men. Thank you for representing the city of Temecula like you have, not just by winning, but by being gentlemen as well. Thank you.
Thank you very much.
We have a Jack Williams. Yes, sir. Come on.
Mystery,
you know,
guest.
Wait, I got to tell you something. We don't break protocol here. There's probably only maybe one or two people in this city who can walk to the podium and speak and break protocol. And you happen to be one of them, Mr. Williams. Okay, so go for it.
Thank you so much. Everything you guys, all of you, ladies and gentlemen, do is so appreciated and respected. I just want to share a little bit what I think is a jewel in this city, in addition to our leadership, is these young men that were up here. They love the Lord, they love the game, they're great students, and they got an incredible coach, and we're just so super blessed to have someone like this in our community. It just makes our community even a little bit better, a little bit better, a little bit better. And that's where we are, because we got a lot of part of our community that's just like these guys right here. And these guys are winners, big winners.
Yes, sir.
Thank you very much, Mayor.
Okay, so we're about to start the public comment portion of our meeting. I assume we have public comments. I see Jillian Larson in the audience, and I'm already tired from all this, and I know she's going to take us for a run. God bless you, Jillian. Okay. All right. And I mean that with all love and sincerity, because we're going to hear about the reality rally. I'm almost certain of it. So how many public speakers do we have, Madam City Clerk?
Mr. Mayor, it looks like we have 5 public speakers.
Sounds good. We're going to wait for the room just a few seconds to clear out. No, better yet, I'll read the rules, which are totally boring, while the room's clearing out. How's that? A total of 30 minutes is provided for members of the public to address the City Council on items that appear within the consent calendar or a matter not listed on the agenda. Each speaker is limited to 3 minutes. If the speaker chooses to address the City Council on an item listed on the consent calendar or a matter not listed on the agenda, a request to speak form may be filled out and filed with the City Clerk prior to the City Council addressing public comments and the consent calendar. Once the speaker is called to speak, please come forward and state your name for the record. For all public, I sort of want to do this in the announcer voice, but that would be pushing it too far. For all public hearing or council business items on the agenda, a request to speak form may be filled and filed with the City Clerk prior to the City Council addressing that item. Each speaker is limited to 5 minutes. Madam City Clerk, call the first speaker, please.
Mr. Mayor, the first speaker is Jillian Larson, to be followed by Monty Sharp.
Jillian is always welcome.
Thank you.
You're welcome.
Come on, little reality rally. Good evening, Mayor, Honorable Mayor, and City Council members, and staff, and commissioners, and everybody who's watching Channel 3, I presume, at home. So the first thing is that I'd like to congratulate our team from Temecula City Council. You guys, you almost You almost beat the Lake Elsinore Victors by 2 minutes. I think that's applause worthy, because that was amazing. So we are Reality Rally. We represent 400 people who put the event on, raising money for Michelle's Place, and Kim Goodnow's part of that, obviously. So 2 minutes. I mean, that is pretty amazing. Now, I have some photos for you guys, so you can take these home and show everybody that you actually did do an amazing job. So there's one for each of the team, and Fire Chief Brown, I don't know if he's back there, one for him as well, and there are plenty, because I'd like your whole city council and city staff to have one each, but please make sure. There's also one for the commissioners, and there's really a blackmail-worthy picture of you right there, so that's it.
Zach.
So, however, 2 minutes is 2 minutes in a game. 2 minutes in the life of somebody going through breast cancer is a very long time, and that's what we do. 2 minutes reaches the world, and part of what I've given you is the stats from this year. Each one of you can read where we reach. Now, on April 1st, I did a random post on Facebook and said that Temecula is honoring one of our own who had fallen. Somebody in Michigan picked that up, and he had something to do about that. So I have a video that I'd like you to watch, and then I'm going to show you something else. But this is part of what Reality Rally is all about, is reaching out with the ripples that touch people all over the world that make a difference. So let's watch that video and see what you think.
Well, my name is Jeremiah Morey. I was on the show Utopia, and I'm also a disabled Marine Corps veteran. And the back of my shirt was done in honor of a brother that has fallen that I'd never met. But I am not the red carpet type of cat, so I would rather have the focus on an actual true hero and to have that, the goodwill spread there, and just to let his family know and friends that this brother will be missed and dearly loved.
So I wanted you to know that this is how the Ripples of Reality Rally reach out. There are so many stories, and I want to thank everybody that is part of Reality Rally. You can see they're from young to old that make Reality Rally happen. So thank you, guys. And Jeremiah approached me at the end of the event, and he handed me the shirt, and he said, could I please do something with it? So I have the shirt here, and this is the front of it. And he wore it the entire weekend, and I said I would do something with it, and here we are doing something with it to begin with, and then beyond that, I would like that we can do something with that, and that can be up to whomever wants to pick up that shirt and make that happen. So thank you, guys. 2 minutes, pretty amazing. And thank to everybody that's part of Reality Rally. Our young filmmakers made some videos you'll be seeing, and the gunfighters are a huge part of it. They're the ones who get the whole game going, so they're always fun. And of course, our main people who run Reality Rally. So please make sure you take your pictures and share it. Look at the stats. They're pretty amazing again. Where do people come from? And to make sure that Zach and Cicely, I think I saw her, get that picture as well. So thank you for supporting what we do. It's an absolute honor, and I love, there were 7 city council people, teams playing this year. That was amazing. And you guys, 2 minutes.
2 minutes, so close.
Once again, an amazing event that not only just was for a great local cause, but was carried across the United States, and as you and I talked about, really around the world in some ways, and all for a good cause. I know you have Kim Goodnow here with you. All the funds that you raised went toward Michelle's Place for breast cancer treatment, and Kim, you want to say a few quick words as to what Michelle's Place does here locally in town?
Thanks for the minutes. What place did they get?
They came in, I think, at 16th, but oh. 2 minutes behind the victors.
It was my first time playing. 76. It was my very first time playing. We came in 13th. I was kind of proud of that.
So are you saying your team beat the city council
we
team?
Did.
Is that what you're trying
That's what
to
I'm say? Saying.
Okay, I got it.
And we were the first. This is the first time Michelle's Place staff participated in the race.
Uh-huh.
You, whatever you want to use that information for, it's up to you.
Getting better and better.
Just keep digging in. Just keep doing it.
I know, and I have CDBG at the end of this meeting, so I'll slow down now. But Michelle's Place is a breast cancer resource center local here. It's on Jefferson Street in Temecula, and we are a direct service center. So we provide free mammograms, ultrasounds, biopsies, surgeon consults, all the way to diagnosis of breast cancer. We also have a complete center full of wigs, prosthesis, support groups, library, financial assistance. What we say is if we don't have it, we'll find it for you. So we're providing, last year we provided over 12,000 free resources to women and their families in Temecula. So what Jillian and her team of Reality Rally does obviously makes a huge impact, not just in reach, in outreach, but in funds delivered to Michelle's Place to help us do what we do. So we're super grateful, and thanks for playing along.
Thank you.
Thank you, guys.
We'll find a good place for that shirt, Mr. City Manager. Maybe put it in a frame and find a place somewhere in City Hall.
Thank you. I will let him know. He's knows that we're presenting it this evening, and we'll be sending him the archives to go and watch.
Thank you very much.
Thank you, guys.
And if I know you, you're already starting on next year's rally.
A few months ago, yes.
Yeah, there you go.
So thank you. I'm going to get you.
Next speaker, please. That's it.
What protocol?
Mayor,
the protocol's out the door tonight, okay, which is totally okay.
Mr. Mayor, the next speaker is Monty Sharp, to be followed by Walt Combs.
Monty, come on down. We don't see it. Monty, come on down.
Really.
Sound like a game show, Walt. But it's always a pleasure to see you.
My blessing always. Mr. Mayor and Honorable Council and staff, I'm here representing Cast a Shadow and Student Venture, and we just love Temecula. You know, I just can't thank you enough for who you are. I've lived here for so many years, and we've watched Jesus just raise this community up in such a phenomenal way, and all of you have had such an amazing part of that. Thank you for the work that you do. We pray for you often and really appreciate who you are and what you do, so thank you. But that's not why I'm here. We had the privilege of being able to put on an event this last weekend. It was the first annual Old Town Temecula Grand Prix, which is a cycling race, and Learn to Live to 100 Health Fair. And we just wanted to say thank you to this council for allowing us to be able to do it, to a staff, a great staff, especially Don and her crew. They are just amazing. Our mayor pro tem, Marianne Edwards, represented the council and the city phenomenally. In fact, you can probably see one or two of the pictures up there. We had the pro writers all come up in the line there, introduced the leading pro writers. Marianne leaves the podium where she was going to be singing the national anthem, walks out into the street and introduces herself to every one of them, welcomes them, and thanks them for being there. It was just so perfect representation of the great relationships we have in this community and the way people feel about it. And we just wanted to say thank you. We believe truly that Temecula represents a place where there's healthy lifestyles and healthy families. And that's what we wanted to do with the Old Town Temecula Grand Prix Cycling Race and Learn to Live to 100 Health Fair, to help people realize that, help develop that, and help continue to promote that. And we had such great feedback from all the National Cycling Association guys that were there, the riders that were there, all the health fair vendors that were there, and our sponsors that were there. And we're really excited about doing it again this next year, making it an annual event. The other part of that was kind of unexpected is we discovered a hidden treasure in our business park. Mm-hmm. Most people don't know how beautiful it is. We actually camped overnight on one of the properties out there because we had to get up at 4 o'clock in the morning. And it was like being someplace, you know, that you go on vacation on. And most people don't even realize that. So on behalf of all the volunteers and staff and sponsors, thank you so very much for allowing us to do it, always being there to support this community and help us to be successful in that. Appreciate it very much. Now you'll hear from some of these guys. I'll give you some specifics. Yes, Mike.
Well, you know what, Jonathan, can we run that loop? Can we run the photo loop again at least once or twice so that people can get an idea? It was a phenomenally well-run and well-attended event. And I went down to talk to the cyclists because there were world-class cyclists there, people who participate in these races all around the world. And for a first-time event, it was absolutely flawless. And the business park is a fabulous place to do this because it's a perfect circle. And I didn't realize that there was quite a hill in the business park. But listening to the riders, it was a killer hill, and they loved the course.
That's when they kicked that motor in.
Yeah, exactly. Yeah. The fact that they had a special needs component and added that to the race, too, it was absolutely delightful. So we had world-class cyclists here on Sunday, and there's a fabulous picture right there that gives an idea. So this is an event I think we should promote and sponsor every single year. On a Sunday afternoon, it was wonderful. You did a fantastic job, all of you.
Had a great team here, huh? Would you like to say something?
Sure.
This is Jay Sikorski, and this was his vision. He actually happens to be married to my daughter, which makes him even better. But come on up, Jay.
I got a slideshow, too, here. I can put that going for
sure.
You. Sure. On site. Move it. It works out well enough for you. But first, I want to say thank you again for all. First, I really want to hit the heart of this race. And you can see that picture right there, and that's what hits me in the heart, are kids, the opportunity for kids, especially the differently abled, to come out and feel like they're the same. And for me to hear something, and I quote from a mother that participated in this and brought her children there. It says, so often I bring my children to an event where only one can participate. But this event allowed both my children, one being differently abled, to enjoy the activities together. Yes, I bring a race, I bring world-class racers, yes, but that's not the point. We're raising up kids in this world to change the hearts of many. And this is the point of this race. This is the drive of it. I bring tons of racers. These guys love it, but the kids love it even more. And when they saw the wall of bubbles, that they were racing to, they zoned in and they moved through it. There were superheroes. There was bouncies. There was jumpsies. This was the point. Face painting was a hit. The kids loved it. We brought health. We brought environment. We brought adrenaline to the loop itself. That's our drive. That's our purpose. And with that, we want to raise up money, and that's our goal, is to raise up money to produce these bikes that are called adaptive bikes that gets the differently abled on those bikes early so they can learn to walk. We take it for granted here, sitting down, walking to our car, and getting back in.
I love the race. I love the cycling. I race myself and I enjoy the adrenaline. But when I see kids able to do the same that we do, it changes my life. It changes my life. So that's my drive, and I'm excited to bring it to Temecula continually, and that's going to be my passion, to bring more activities, to bring a fair, to bring kids to be able to do something. Why this adrenaline sport's going on? How to learn to live to 100 health fair? This is the point. This is the passion. This is the drive. And I thank you for supporting it this year, and we had an exciting time.
Thank you.
It was really good.
I think they said it pretty much all.
Hold on, Doc. Dr. Combs, right?
Yeah.
Dr. Combs is my doctor, and I don't usually get him in this position. So before you leave, you need to leave a copay. Okay. Okay. $15 to the city clerk before you leave here.
I thought you were going to ask for some advice.
Okay.
they really said it all, but I'd never been to a race like this. I've never seen anything like it. It was really fun. Mm-hmm. And the great thing they did is they incorporated everyone, old people, young people. You could race, everybody could race. It was really, really fun, and all classes of racers. And I think the health fair, the race, could be a really big deal for Temecula in the future. And I just want to thank everybody for supporting it. Thanks.
Thank you. All done? Got it. Madam
Good job,
clerk,
you guys.
Any more speakers?
Yes, Mr. Mayor. Actually, the next two speakers were Walt and Jay, so I'm going to assume that was for the same subject. Right. And then the next and final speaker is Cecily Nelson.
Hello, Ms. Nelson.
Hi, good evening, everybody. Everybody watching, everybody in the audience, and council and staff, and my fellow commissioners, and everybody. I'm here. Don't make me laugh. That's Councilmember McCracken. I'm here. I'm representing both my role as a community services commissioner as well as my affiliation with NAREP, which is the National Association of Hispanic Real Estate Professionals. I serve on the local North County chapter board as their board secretary in my profession as a realtor. And I had the privilege of seeing a play that NAREP is producing and has sponsored, $53 million in one, back in November in San Diego. And when I saw it, it kind of raised all these emotions, because it's a story about one person who's made their way for their family, in their profession, amassed great success, but the road that he took to get there. And I thought, it's certainly a story of one with a Latin and Hispanic background, but one that can resonate with people of all cultures. And I thought, as the as one of our community services commissioners, I thought it speaks to why I'm so proud to serve here and why I'm so proud to live here. And I thought this would benefit our residents in terms of being able to view it and come. So we're holding it on May 5th, Cinco de Mayo, at 6 p.m. at the Old Town Temecula Community Theater. There's a free reception from 6 to 7, and then the program starts at 7 p.m. And you don't have to be a real estate agent. You don't have to be of Latino or Hispanic descent. It's for everybody. It's for family. Parents, bring your kids. I just wanted to warmly invite everyone to come out and see this show, because I think it speaks a lot to what we've seen demonstrated here tonight with respect to diversity, strength, commitment, motivation, perseverance, and just overall genuine caring for all of us as neighbors and friends in the city of Temecula. So that's my invitation. I hope you'll come and join me. I will be there, and thank you.
Thank you very much. I think that does it for public speakers, right? Okay, we'll move to city council reports. Press your buttons. Anybody gonna get in the queue? Council member Ron.
Well, just really briefly, I wanted to thank Jillian and all the folks on the reality rally. It was a lot of fun for us. Just to clarify, though, just to clarify and set the record straight, how many teams were at the reality rally? 76. So our city council team took 16th place out of 76 teams. That's not bad. And as a nod to, of course, Michelle's place, we couldn't beat you guys, right? We had to let you go before us. So that was really all that was. But really, it was a wonderful event. It grows every year, and it's really becoming one of the signature events for our city. And I'm looking forward to, at some point in the future, bringing forward a video of our own fire chief wearing a red female cowboy hat or cowgirl hat. Riding the bull at the stampede for approximately 1 second. So I'll be looking forward. I know he wasn't here today, so I didn't. I decided it's only best to bring that forward when he is here. But, you know, I would really appreciate your help in bringing as many of the folks from the department to witness this, because it really is a once-in-a-lifetime opportunity. So
you
anyway,
didn't ride
thank
the
you
bull?
So much for putting that on. Appreciate it.
No, Ms. Dr. Ron, you didn't ride the bull?
Oh, not a chance, no. No, not at all.
Funny. Councilmember McCracken.
Yes, to Jillian. In respect to the race you put on, the reality race, the amazing thing about the entire race is that there was one organization who deserves all the credit and all the attention. They won. It was our first time entering the race as council members, and out of everybody that was there, I was amazed to see how many people that were not participating were cheering us on. So it was a total city event, going through Old Town, going through the swap meet. So to Michelle's place, we may have come in 16th place, but I think Michelle's place came in first place regardless. So the attention was there, the money was raised, and it had the right ending. So I enjoyed it. I'll do it again next year.
Thank you for being part of it too. Thank you.
Thank you. And I just have a couple of things real quick. First, I want to congratulate you, organizers of the Grand Prix. You know, it really touches me in a way I just can't express your special needs component. And what also is amazing to me that on the complete other side of the city, our community service department was holding the special games. And our staff did such a great job, but even more so, were all the peer buddies who came out. And I think we had about maybe 250 kiddos and as many peer buddies that just escorted them throughout each and every station. Boy, Temecula has heart. That's all I could say.
Watch
and it's just a family-friendly, family-first community. And on that note, this year's theme for the state of the city is Family First. I have the honor of giving it this Thursday morning at 7 a.m. at Pechanga Resort. I hope to see you all there. If by chance you're not able to make it, I'm going to be hopeful to try to take one or two times out into the community, maybe at some HOAs or maybe Wolf Creek Fire Station, Harveston area, something like that, and give a mini presentation so all the citizens can come out and see it. But it was a good weekend in Temecula, a very good weekend. Without any further ado, unless Mr. McCracken.
Yes, Mr. Mayor, for those of you who don't know what a peer buddy is, it is a person, normally a student, who goes with a special needs person so they can enjoy the whole entire event. The first time I've seen it, I thought it was pretty awesome. So a lot of people, they take it for granted what a peer buddy is. When I first went there, I was surprised to see so many people participating. And I got a chance to talk to the kids that were with the special needs. And just to see the look on their face, they were having just as much fun as a person participating in the Olympics.
Well, thanks for clarifying that, because the peer buddies were high school kids and high young people who took their Saturday morning to come out and do this. It's an amazing day in Temecula. All right, we're going to move to the consent calendar portion of our meeting. I have to read the rules, forgive me. All matters listed under the consent calendar are considered to be routine and will be enacted by one roll call vote. There will be no discussion on these items unless council members or members of the unless members of the city council request specific items be removed from the consent calendar for separate action. Number one will be waive the reading of standard ordinances and resolutions. Item two, approve the action minutes of April 12, 2016. Item 3, approve the list of demands, and I'm going to abstain from one item on that, and the city attorney will elaborate there in a minute. Item 4, approve the Fourth Amendment to the agreement with Environmental Science Associates for the preparation of supplemental environmental impact report for the Temecula Valley Hospital heliport relocation. It's my understanding Councilmember Comacchero will be abstaining from that because he's on the board of that hospital. 5, approve the First Amendment to the agreement with Blanco Y. Price for landscape plan review and inspection services for fiscal year 2015 and 16. 6, approve an amendment for consultant services with Michael Baker International Company for Pechanga Parkway widening. That's good news. Via Gilberto to North Casino Drive, Public Works 15-4. Mr. Comacchero, did you want to add anything to what I said regarding your abstention?
No, thank you, but I would just like to reiterate that I will be abstaining on item 4 due to a position on the governing board of Temecula Valley Hospital.
Very good. And Mr. City Attorney, could you please clarify my abstention?
Yes, Mr. Mayor. Mayor Nagar is going to abstain on item number 3, and in particular, check number 176083. That was a check made out to him as reimbursement for his purchase of a city-owned computer, and that's an entirely legitimate and inappropriate transaction, but under the FPPC rules, he doesn't need to abstain on that.
Thank you. So with the noted abstention, I'll take a motion to approve the consent calendar.
And just real quickly, Unless those two items are pulled off the consent calendar, neither one of you needs to leave the chamber.
Thank you, Mr. City Attorney.
Approval.
Second.
So the motion was by Mayor Pro Tem Edwards. The second was by Councilmember McCracken. With the noted abstentions, please cast your vote. And that carries, again, 5-0 with the notice, with the abstentions noted. At this time, I'm going to recess the Temecula Council meeting and turn the gavel over to President Jeff Comacchero of the Temecula Community Service District.
I thank you, Mr. Mayor. I'd like to call this meeting of the Temecula Community Services District to order. Madam Clerk, we are all here this evening. Do we have any public comment under this portion? Thank you. The answer was no. We have two items on consent calendar this evening. Item 7, approve the action minutes of April 12, 2016. And item 8, approve an agreement with Sherry Berry Music for concession services at the Old Town Temecula Community Theater.
Move consent.
Second.
We have a motion by the mayor, second by the mayor pro tem. Please cast your votes. Please cast your votes.
Thank you.
Motion carries unanimously 5-0. That's it for our agenda. Our Director of Community Services had some family issues, not here tonight, but Bea, do you have anything to say?
Nothing to report tonight, Mr. President. Thank you.
Thank you. Mr. General Manager?
Nothing further.
Thank you. I would just like to have it be known that Mr. Adams and I participated in the first reality rally and won. We didn't
That's
finish
right.
16th. We didn't finish second. Anyway, so much for that.
There's probably a photo out there someplace, right, Julian? We can bring that one back.
I thought we had the
you
best
don't
time.
Have to if you don't want to. I'd be all right.
I thought we had the fastest time, though, right, Matt?
What's that?
We had the fastest time, though, right, Matt?
Yeah, whatever you say.
Did Michelle's Place participate that year? Yeah, see, Michelle's Place didn't participate.
But Michelle's Place always wins. So.
That's right.
I was working.
All right, let's move on. It's getting kind of thick in here. Do we have any further comments from the board of directors? Seeing none, we'll entertain a motion to adjourn to May 10th. We have a motion and a second. Any objection?
Nope.
Seeing none, we'll stand adjourned.
Okay, at this time I'm going to call to order the Joint City Council, Temecula Public Financing Authority public hearing. We'll move to Mr. City Attorney. Do I need to read the rules?
Yes, you should.
Okay, then let's read the rules because we do have a public hearing. Any person may submit written comments to the Board of Directors before a public hearing or may appear and be heard in support of or in opposition to the approval of the projects at the time of the hearing. If you challenge any of the projects in court, you may be limited to raising only those issues you or someone else raised at the public hearing or in a written correspondence delivered to the city clerk at or prior to the public hearing. So we have item 9, that's the formation of a Temecula Public Financing Authority Community Facilities District, number 16-01, Warpaw Ranch, Phase 2. Councilmember Comacchero and myself will be abstaining from this issue because it is a public hearing. We'll have to leave the dais and also leave the room. Mr. City Attorney, would you elaborate on that, please?
Yes, I do need to make a brief statement here that's required by the FPPC rules, and that is that Mayor Nagar and Councilmember Comacchero will not be participating on item 9 of the Joint City Council Temecula Public Financing Authority agenda. Europa Vineyard Estates is located on approximately 290 acres southeasterly of Butterfield Stage Road in La Serena Way in unincorporated Riverside County. It has been owned by Temecula Vineyard Estates, LLC, and is adjacent to Butterfield Stage Road. Neither Mayor Mike Nagar nor Councilmember Jeff Comacchero has any direct investment or ownership interest in Temecula Vineyard Estates. The managing member of Temecula Vineyard Estates, LLC, has been Mr. Daniel Stevenson. Mayor Nagar and Councilmember Comacchero do, however, have ownership interests and are members of other limited liability companies that are developing property outside the city of Temecula, in which Mr. Stevenson is also the managing member. Europa Vineyard Estates is therefore an otherwise related business entity for those officials within the meaning of Section 18703.1 of the FPPC regulations. Europa Vineyard Estates is now owned by an entity related to Temecula Vineyard Estates LLC called Syrah Development Corporation, Inc., of which Councilmember Comacchero is an officer. The proposed actions on item 9, initiating new and restructured CFD bonds for the Warpaw Ranch project, will have no material financial effect, indeed no effect, on Europa Vineyard Estates or the owners of the project, for the simple reason that these actions do not change the Warpaw Ranch developers' obligations to construct the Phase 3 improvements on Butterfield Stage Road from what had been required since approval of the original development agreement and specific plan in 2002. This is consistent with the FPPC legal staff's March 2008 opinion relating to the Calexico property that allowed Mayor Nagar and Councilmember Comacchero's participation in a decision to acquire property located 372 feet south of Europa Vineyard Estates necessary for construction of Phase 3. Additionally, the funding for the Phase 3 improvements for Butterfield Stage Road has been in place since Warpaw Ranch Community Facilities District 0302 issued Community Facility District special tax bonds in April 2006. I have determined that Mayor Nagar and Councilmember Comacchero may participate in the consideration of Item 9 of the Joint City Council TPFA agenda, initiating the new and restructured bonds for the project. Mayor Nagar and Councilmember Comacchero have, however, chosen not to participate in these actions involving the new bonds and will leave the council chamber.
Thank you.
I apologize for the length of that, but that is required by the FPPC rules.
You got it. Young people, there'll be a test on that later. At this time, go ahead, Councilmember.
Just to be clear, the last statement made by the city attorney is that we do not legally, technically have a conflict. We choose not to participate out of an abundance of caution and because of the perception of the community.
Exactly. So at this time, I'm going to turn the meeting over to Vice Mayor, Mayor Pro Tem, Mary Ann Edwards, and we will leave the room.
Thank you, gentlemen. And we will wait until the door closes behind you. All right. So for the sake of the record, Madam City Clerk, could you please call the roll and reflect who is present and who is not?
Director Comacchero and Director Nagar are absent. All other directors are present.
Thank you very much. All right, we will be considering item 9, the formation of the Temecula Public Financing Authority Community Facilities District, number 16-01, Warpaw Ranch, Phase 2. So could we have a staff report, please?
Yes, Madam Mayor, council members, directors. This evening, we continue the process of refinancing the existing Warpaw Ranch CFD through the formation of a new CFD 16-01, Warpaw Ranch, Phase 2. Recall that our March 22nd City Council/Public Financing Authority meeting, this process was initiated and tonight's public hearing was noticed and set. There are several actions being considered this evening. The first order of business is to, as the City Council, approve a joint community facilities agreement, or JCFA, between the City and the Temecula Public Financing Authority. Because the authority is a separate legal entity, state law requires that the City enter into a JCFA with the authority, because a majority of the improvements to be financed by the CFD will be owned by the City. Additionally, the services to be funded by the CFD will be provided by the City. The requisite JCFA included in your agenda packet this evening has been drafted by the City's Bond Counsel, Paul Timig, and meets the statutory requirements. The JCFA also provides that the City will assist the authority in connection with the use of bond proceeds to acquire public improvements. Staff recommends that the agreement be approved by the City Council and be executed by the City and the authority so that the authority can adopt a resolution authorizing the issuance of special tax bonds for the new CFD in June. This concludes my report for item 9.1 on the agenda. Staff and Bond Counsel are available to answer any of your questions.
Thank you, Mr. Butler. Okay, for item 9.1, are there any questions? No? And no? All right, then I would accept a motion.
Motion.
Second. A motion for item 9.1.
Oh, second.
A resolution of the City Council of the City of Temecula approving joint community facilities agreement relating to the financing of public improvements and implementation of acquisition agreement. Okay, so I've got a motion and a second, and you may press your buttons and vote, please. And that vote reflects 3 council members present and 2 abstaining. Or do I count them as absent?
Count them as absent.
Absent, all right. 2 absent. Thank you very much. And we can move on to items 9.2, 0.3, and 0.4. So could we have a staff report on those items, please?
Thank you, ma'am. Yes, the next few items on the agenda follow the prescribed steps necessary to form the Royal Palm Ranch Phase 2 CFD. Paul Timig, the City's Bond Counsel, is here this evening to walk you through the balance of the actions on the agenda. Paul.
Good evening.
Good evening, Mayor Pro Tem and council members. Tonight, we are going to proceed with what was started on March 22nd when you adopted 2 resolutions of intention to form this new CFD, the goal being to both separate the undeveloped property in Roarpaw Ranch from the developed property so that we can refinance the outstanding bonds, save the taxpayers money, and then raise new money to help develop the undeveloped portion of Roarpaw Ranch. The initial 3 resolutions are a resolution of formation of the new community facilities district, a resolution of necessity to incur bonded indebtedness. The bonded indebtedness limit is set at $60 million. Approximately half of that is needed to refinance the portion of the outstanding bonds attributable to the undeveloped property. The other half is ability to finance some new improvements. We probably won't issue the whole $60 million when we come back in June. There isn't sufficient value to support that, but we will be asking you to approve those bonds so that we can both refinance that portion of the outstanding bonds and raise a significant amount of money to complete infrastructure needed for the development of the undeveloped portion. And then lastly, there's a resolution calling a special election to form a community facilities district. It takes a 2/3 vote. There's less than 12 registered voters in the district. It's a vote by property owners. Here, there's no registered voters. We have 2 property owners. They petitioned for this community facilities district, and they've already submitted their ballots so that after the 3rd resolution is considered and hopefully adopted, we can hold the election right away and then canvass it and move on to commence the actions necessary to levy taxes to support the bonded indebtedness. The community facilities district, the authorized taxes can only be levied on property in the community facilities district. The bonds will not be general obligation bonds of the city. They'll be supported solely by the special tax revenues on the property that the community facilities district includes. That concludes my remarks. I'm happy to answer any questions that you may have about what we're doing tonight.
Thank you. Are there any questions? No?
Thank you.
Okay. No? So then I need to open the public hearing on this. So this is now the time and place for the public hearing in this Board of Directors proceedings for the Temecula Public Financing Authority Community Facilities District Number 16-01, Roar Paw Ranch Phase 2. The hearing is to inquire into the formation of the district, the levy of special taxes on property in the district, and the need to incur bonded indebtedness for the district. Before I formally open the hearing, are there any owners of property in the district or registered voters who reside in the district who wish to file written protests against the formation of the district, the special tax levy, or the proposed bond issue for the district? If so, they must be filed with the city clerk as the secretary of authority now. So if anyone is present, you need to come forward, please, and file now with the city clerk. Well, for a minute, Madam City Clerk, I thought you had four.
Madam Chair, I will confirm at this time that there are no protests filed with the city.
All right. So the public hearing is now open. Does anyone in the audience wish to comment?
Madam Chair, we have no public comments.
No. All right, then in consideration, if no other comments or questions, then Board of Directors, that would be you and myself, of the Temecula Public Financing Authority, I will accept a motion on the following three resolutions.
Madam Chair, I will reflect for the record that the public hearing is now closed.
Yes. Oh, there you go.
So moved.
I have to read them first. So, a resolution of the Board of Directors of the Temecula Public Financing Authority of formation of Temecula Public Financing Authority Community Facilities District Number 1601, Roar Paw Ranch Phase 2, authorizing the levy of a special tax within the district, preliminarily establishing an appropriations limit for the district, and submitting levy of the special tax and of the establishment of the appropriations limit to the qualified electors of the district. Next item, a resolution of the Board of Directors of the Temecula Public Financing Authority determining the necessity to incur bonded indebtedness within Temecula Public Financing Authority Community Facilities District Number 1601, Roar Paw Ranch Phase 2, and submitting proposition to the qualified electors of the district. And finally, a resolution of the Board of Directors of the Temecula Public Financing Authority calling special election within Community Facilities District Number 16-01, Roar Paw Ranch Phase 2. So I will accept a motion.
So moved.
And second.
So I have a motion and a second. So if you will cast your vote. And that is approved, 3-2 absent. At this time, I ask the city clerk as secretary of the Temecula Public Financing Authority to open the ballots and announce the results of the election.
The suspense is killing me.
Madam Chair, for the record, both property owners have voted in the affirmative.
All right, very good. In that case, we will move on to number 8, which is board consideration of items 9.3 and 9.4. And unless there are any additional questions or comments, I will ask for a motion on these items. So then we need to read the resolution and ask the city attorney to read the ordinance title. So we've got adoption of a resolution of the Board of Directors of the Temecula Public Financing Authority declaring results of special election and directing recording of notice of special tax lien, Community Facilities District Number 16-01, Roar Paw Ranch Phase 2. And then the city attorney.
And the ordinance is an ordinance of the Temecula Public Financing Authority levying special taxes within Temecula Public Financing Authority Community Facilities District Number 16-01, Warapah Ranch Phase 2.
And I will ask for a motion and a second.
Move approval.
Second.
Okay, so if you would cast your votes, please. And it is 3-2 absent. All right, very good. And do we have any director reports?
None.
Seeing none, I will call this meeting without objection adjourned. And we can have our absentees come back. Or we could just take full control and take over the world at this point.
Thank you. Where'd you leave off?
Congratulations. You're ready to go to page 8.
Did you adjourn this meeting?
I did.
Sound like
okay, so. Let's see here. We're going to reconvene the Temecula City Council meeting. Go to item 10. That's a public hearing. Mr. City Attorney, do I need to read the rules for public hearings again?
Yes, you do. It's the CFD, or Community Block Grant Development public hearing.
Very good. Public hearing. Let's see if I can do it like I'm quoting Shakespeare. Any person may submit written comments to the City Council before a public hearing, or may appear and be heard in support of or in opposition to the approval of the projects at the time of the hearing. If you challenge any of the projects in court, you may be limited to raising only those issues you or someone else raised at the public hearing or in written correspondence delivered to the city clerk at or prior to the public hearing. Item 10, approval of the Community Development Block Grant, known as CDBG, Annual Action Plan and Funding Recommendations for the fiscal year 2016 and 17. Staff report, please.
Hi. Good evening, Mayor Nagar and members of the council. My name is Lynn Kelly Lehner, and I am a senior management analyst in community development. Tonight, I am here to present the annual action plan recommendations for the Community Development Block Grant 2016-17 program year. CDBG is a federal program that strives to create the development of viable urban communities by promoting, preserving, and assisting in the development of affordable housing, improving and expanding infrastructure and facilities, providing and improving access to public services, and providing for economic development needs. From 1992 through 2012, the city participated in the Riverside County EDA CDBG program. In 2012, City Council adopted the first 5-year consolidated plan and became an entitlement city, authorizing Temecula to receive CDBG funds directly from HUD. Our CDBG program is guided by two documents, the Consolidated Plan and the Annual Action Plan. The Consolidated Plan is used as a framework for the city to assess its housing and community development needs and identify its priority projects. The city is required to complete one every 5 years. 2016-17 is the final year of the current Consolidated Plan, and staff is already working with a consultant to begin the process on our next plan. As an entitlement community, the city is required to prepare an annual action plan to notify citizens and HUD of the city's intended actions during that particular program year. The plan serves as a guide on how the city intends to utilize the allotted funds and to address priority objectives that will produce the greatest impact on the local community. The annual action plan must be submitted to HUD by May 15th. Both the Consolidated Plan and Annual Action Plan are collaborative processes to establish the needs of the community. During our application period for program year 16-17, staff held 2 community workshops in December. These workshops were intended to both solicit input from stakeholders and to provide technical assistance to potential applicants. The Finance Subcommittee, consisting of Mayor Nagar and Mayor Pro Tem Edwards, met on February 9th to consider the CDBG funding proposals and provide recommendations. At this public meeting, all applicants were invited to attend, as well as members of the public. The plan was available for a 30-day public review period, which culminates with this evening's public hearing. The city's allocation for the upcoming program year is approximately $515,000. This represents a 5% decrease from the February 9th Finance Subcommittee meeting. The city received a letter from HUD dated February 16th, indicating the city's official allocation for the upcoming year. In order for the city to meet HUD's national objectives, the subcommittee recommended a maximum of 20%, approximately $103,000, to be allocated for program administration. This includes staff time and consulting costs. The subcommittee also recommended a maximum of 15%, or approximately $77,000, to be allocated to nonprofit public service providers. The remainder, or 65%, approximately $335,000, may be allocated to public capital improvement projects. The city received 14 public service funding requests, totaling roughly $277,000. The city also received one request for housing activities from Habitat for Humanity that may utilize capital funds that will be discussed later in the presentation. As previously mentioned, a maximum of approximately $77,000 may be allocated for public services. The subcommittee made recommendations to fund 9 nonprofit service providers, as demonstrated on the chart on the screen, in particular a $10,000 recommendation to the Fair Housing Council. Subsequent to the February 9th meeting, the city received a letter from the Fair Housing Council of Riverside County. The Fair Housing Council conducts mandatory fair housing, discrimination, and landlord-tenant services, and typically receives a reasonable percentage of the annual allocation to provide these mandatory services to Temecula residents. In their letter, Fair Housing raised concerns regarding the recommended funding allocation. According to the letter, based on the current recommendation, Fair Housing will be unable to provide adequate services for the entire fiscal year. As an entitlement city and under HUD requirements, the city must affirmatively further fair housing and is required to provide fair housing services. Because the city neither has the staffing levels nor the expertise to handle the high volume of fair housing concerns, the city has partnered with Fair Housing to provide these services to our residents since 2012. As such, staff is requesting that the City Council reconsider funding the Fair Housing Council at their full request of $16,810. Consequently, this change will affect the funding allocations for the remainder of the nonprofit service providers. This table represents the original subcommittee recommendation, as well as the revised recommendation that reflects both the 5% reduction from HUD and funding the Fair Housing Council at their full request. Each recommendation was reduced proportionately. The revised recommendation is to fund 7 nonprofits at $8,283. They include the Assistance League of Temecula Valley, Safe Alternatives for Everyone, or SAFE, Senior Citizen Service Center, VNW Circle of Care, Team Temecula Community Pantry, Community Mission of Hope, and Michelle's Place. One nonprofit service provider, Canine Support Teams, is recommended to receive $2,556, and Fair Housing Council is recommended to receive $16,810. After administration and nonprofit service providers, the remainder of our CDBG allocation, approximately $335,000, was recommended to be allocated towards public infrastructure projects. The subcommittee recommended the following allotments for the capital facility projects and housing activities. The Habitat for Humanity Critical Home Maintenance Program proposes to provide services to 15 low-income homeowners and is recommended to be funded at $25,000. The Sam Hicks Monument Playground Project will replace the existing dilapidated park playground with a new local history-themed playground. Additional funds are being requested due to unanticipated challenges during the fabrication and design phases and to work with geotechnical and structural consultants. It is recommended to be funded at $64,681. The Old Town Sidewalk Improvement Project includes the design and construction of a segment of sidewalk located in Old Town on the east side of Mercedes from Sam Hicks to 4th Street and is recommended to be funded at $220,520. The Rotary Park Rehabilitation Project includes the design and construction of a new irrigation system, landscaping, and hardscaping. The park serves as a low-income neighborhood and is recommended to be funded at $25,000. And finally, the Temecula Community Center Phase 2 project includes the replacement of the hardwood flooring in the TCC. Since the subcommittee meeting, staff has identified an alternate solution to prolonging the life of the flooring. If additional funding becomes available, it is recommended that this project is included as a backup project. With that, tonight's recommendation is that the council approve a resolution of the City Council of the City of Temecula approving the 2016-17 Annual Action Plan as an application to the U.S. Department of Housing and Urban Development for funding under the Federal Community Development Block Grant Program, including the proposed use of funds for fiscal year 2016-17. That concludes my presentation, and I am available if you have any questions. Thank you.
Thank you, Lynn, for a very thorough and detailed good staff report. I appreciate that. Are there any questions of staff at this point? Questions? I don't see any. This is a public hearing, so at this time we're going to open the public hearing. It appears that we have one speaker, Madam City Clerk.
We do, Mr. Mayor. We have one speaker, Kim Goodnow.
And hello again, Kim.
Hi. Mayor Nagar and council members, I just wanted to say thank you so much for your proposed support of Michelle's Place, but your continued support, obviously, through Reality Rally. A really great time, but it's our first time applying for CDBG funds, and we don't take it lightly, so thank you very much for your proposed recommendation and for supporting us. And specifically, this will be helping us facilitate mammograms, ultrasounds, surgical consults, and biopsies, and partially funding a part-time patient navigator, which is going to help women navigate through that medical process.
Thank you. Yeah. I have a question for you. Yeah. How long has Michelle's Place been in business?
It'll be 15 years in November.
Mm-hmm. Is there any possibility or in the future, have you ever thought about expanding your mission to other cancer services?
We actually just changed, did somebody plug this already for you?
No.
We changed our mission statement this year and included a brand new vision statement that says no one should face cancer alone. Because mm-hmm. we currently, you know, just in a year ago, started a ovarian cancer support group through OASIS, which is an ovarian cancer support nonprofit up in Moreno Valley. We have a lot of other women who have other kinds of cancers in our support groups currently, lung cancer, pancreatic cancer, all kinds of different cancers. So we recognize that there's a huge need because there really still is nothing else in the community providing support services for women's cancer, cancer in general. There's a few things. Obviously, we collaborate with Loma Linda and some of the hospitals on things, but there's really no other resources. So we provide free wigs to women who lose their hair from any kind of chemotherapy, et cetera, et cetera. So mm-hmm. we're working towards that. Again, it's tough. I mean, staff, space, money is what it comes down to. But we do have a plan, a business plan, hoping to expand, and not just even here, but I mean, some of the counties are even worse off than even we are.
I'll just my last comment while you're here is, you know, we started a human services department and we're doing a lot of things. We started it because of special needs areas. Mm-hmm. It then branched out and it's doing things in the senior citizen community. And I think that there's a place for it somewhere in the future for more cancer services. So
that would be great.
Maybe we can talk about that in
okay.
the future.
We'd love to.
And we can meet and then maybe see where it goes.
Right. Well, and there's a lot of people who want to help. So I think there's certainly room not only for growth, but for collaboration on many levels. So I'd love to have that conversation.
Beautiful. Thank okay. you very much.
Thank
and thanks
you
for your work.
You're welcome.
We don't have any more speakers, do we? So at this point, we'll close the public hearing and we'll move to council comments.
Move staff report.
We have a motion by Councilmember Comacchero, a second by Vice Mayor Edwards. Is there any further comment?
They do great work.
And excellent, yes. As do all of the ones that we're funding.
Mm-hmm.
Good
please
job.
Cast your vote. And that passes 5-0. Let's see here. City manager report.
Just one quick item, Mr. Mayor. I just want to encourage folks that haven't participated in our online survey. It is available on the city's homepage. We're encouraging everyone to join the conversation. It will only take about a minute and a half of your time, but your opinion matters, and we're looking for what you value in terms of priorities, and we'll be wrapping this up in mid-May, and we really appreciate all those that have already participated, so thank you.
City Attorney report.
Mr. Mayor and members of the council, we have no actions to report from closed session this evening.
Thank you very much. Commissioner Hagel, Traffic Commission. Thank you. Commissioner Telesio, Planning Commission.
Thank you. This is the first time I've been involved with this part of it, so I'd be happy to talk about what we did at our last meeting, and if it gets too lengthy, get the hook. As you know, we aren't the fund commission, but we do enjoy doing things and hearing from people that are enhancing the city's opportunities and making us better than we are already. And in that regard, we started our meeting last week with the a recognition through the business recognition program of Cengage Learning Education 2Go, which is a internet education producing facility that's now located across the street in the second floor of the Truax building. And they run a network of 2,100 top universities and colleges, which includes Mount San Jacinto and Cal State San Marcos in their lineup. And I guess it's a high quality education courses that afford easy and to use through networks of more than the 2,100 colleges and universities, and virtually online college offers the latest instruction online courses from the top professionals in their field. So we've got some good things coming out of the building across the street. In addition, we were pleased to review and ultimately approve the modifications to the Promenade Mall, which is an amazing project. They have decided in their wisdom, Forest City, that big malls are not the thing anymore. It's the outside streetscapes and the smaller boutique stores. So in order to do that, they've decided to take the roof off of the mall, at least most of it, around the Macy buildings, and make a streetscape with shops and additional restaurants, and make it more compatible with what they see as people's desires in modern age. So that's coming and was approved. Lastly, we've reviewed and ultimately approved Aldi Market, which is, if you've been reading about it in the papers. I didn't see Temecula involved in that. When it first started to come out, I looked for it because I was looking for that market. However, I guess it was under the tutelage of the planning department, unbeknownst to us, and it came up on our agenda last week. It's a unique market. There are, I think, 10,000 of them in the world, mostly high-end markets, but in what they're proposing for the United States is more of a limited product, but low-cost variety of household goods and staples. And they're going to be located off of Moraga to the south of Moraga and Rancho California Road to the west of the approved facility for the elderly, and just up from the medical office building and that piece of land that's been there since the Indians were camping on it. So we're going to see that with some development on here in the next future. That's all I have.
Thank you, Commissioner Telesio, for a thorough report. Appreciate that. Commissioner Schwenk.
Thank you, Mr. Mayor. Just a couple quick items. Just a huge, really kudos to staff, the community, the sponsors, everyone that was involved in the special games. So I attended that event again, and this is, you know, every time I go, I'm really just like, you know, it gets you. You see smiles, and from everyone involved, it is really something that the community should come out and witness firsthand. It's really a great event. So huge kudos there. And then our commission reached out to student council kids at Day Middle School, which is the kids you see here in the picture, and Temecula Middle School. And we're basically just reaching out to kids and trying to foster some civic engagement. And these kids are ready to take your job, number one. They're all really excited to get involved. I think we might see some kids before our commission and probably here at the council as well, just talking things that they want to see in their community. And then lastly, my daughter and her school are going on a trip to San Francisco. And you often hear Councilmember McCracken talking about when he travels, he's got his Temecula hat and whatnot. Well, my daughter grabs her City of Temecula junior lifeguard backpack, and she's like, you know, she's proud to go. So you've got a team of little ambassadors in San Francisco this weekend. So I think we'll hear good things from them. Jillian, This looks like a winning team. I don't know what happened. I'm sorry. Thank you. That's all.
Thank you, Commissioner Schwenk. Unless there's anything further from my council colleagues, we'll entertain a motion to adjourn.
So moved.
All in favor?
Aye.
We're adjourned.